big movies, celebrity gossip, and your sport updates, and actual fun stuff to do in Kansas City.
All coming up on SNC Unscripted.
I'm Bill Butts.
And I'm Connor Cape.
You know, Kansas City is a great place filled with a lot of fun things to do. And one of the highlights being the KC Zoo.
It's my favorite.
Oh, absolutely. They have a variety of animals from tigers to monkeys, even a polar bear. So let's go to our reporter, Lindsay Crabtree, for a better look at the KC Zoo. How's everything over there, Lindsay?
Oh my gosh, this is awesome. I think I need a hat.
Woo, hello.
Ready?
Ready. How's my hair?
Beautiful.
All right, want me to do it again? Ready?
Oh my gosh. Get the camera shot.
This is awesome.
Why do they love you?
They love you!
And now to sports. We're halfway through the NFL season, and it's kicking into high gear. The World Series is on the line, the NBA season is nearing, and the MLS playoffs are upon us.
You know, and speaking of the NFL, the Chiefs have caused a stir by naming Brady Quinn the starting quarterback.
Brady Quinn?
Yes, Brady Quinn over Matt Castle. And, well, Matt Castle is coming off a head injury against the Baltimore Ravens. The switch has brought on, you know, various cheers of derision from the fans. The majority believe that neither option can help the hapless franchise.
Neither can. And along the lines of hapless Kansas City sports franchises, the Royals are not playing in the World Series, and nobody is surprised. Instead, the AL Central Division foe Detroit Tigers are in a best-of-seven series against the NL West San Francisco Giants. The Tigers' path to the Fall Classic included a sweep of the New York Yankees, while the Giants had to come from behind in a seven-game series against the St. Louis Cardinals to punch their ticket.
The St. Louis Cardinals?
Yeah. Right.
Well, it's okay, because Kansas City does have a winner.
Finally.
Yes, finally, a team to cheer on for a respective league, okay? Now, the Sporting KC now sits atop the Eastern Conference in the MLS as the playoffs loom. Now, last year, they were knocked out of the conference by the Houston Dynamo. Hopefully this year we're doing a lot better.
Yeah, hopefully. Not this time.
Nah, well, we got it. Well, it's been a minute. Let's go back and check up on Lindsay. Lindsay?
From Africa to Asia, all the way to Australia, the zoo offers a chance to meet and learn about animals from all over the world. Reporting from the Kansas City Zoo, I'm Lindsay Crabtree with JCAV News.
You know, KC does have a great zoo. Another great would definitely be the Sprint Center.
Right.
How about that? You ever actually been to the Sprint Center?
I've been to the Sprint Center multiple times. You know who's coming?
Who?
Justin Bieber.
Biebs! Okay, so the Biebs there. You know, tickets actually cost from $40 to $90 for that.
For the Biebs?
For the Biebs. You know, they had the Red Hot Chili Peppers, even Madonna. It's ridiculous.
What are the ticket prices for Madonna?
You see, this is the kicker here. So we have Justin Bieber, Red Hot Chili Peppers, but of all things, Madonna costs $45 for, like, the worst possible seat.
For the nosebleeds.
Yeah, for the nosebleeds. For the best seats. Now, so let's go back. We're going back to that for a second here. Bieber was $90. Chili Peppers was $50 for a best seat. Madonna was $400 to see Madonna.
You'd have to pay me $400 to go see Madonna.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I don't think I can do it. I couldn't do it. You know, I would rather see Bieber than spend $400 to go see Madonna.
I'd go see the Red Hot Chili Peppers. Out of the three of them, I have to clear that up.
Right with you. But one thing I definitely want to see. Okay, so November 23rd to the 25th. Now, you all probably saw Dark Knight Rises, but how about Batman Live? I'm talking like a musical Batman.
With playing. Batman Live?
Yeah, Batman Live at the Sprint Center.
What is Batman Live?
Batman Live, well, pretty much imagine this. You ever see, like, you know, the Batman with, you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger, that he's, like, skating on ice and all that?
No.
Thankfully, it's nothing like that.
Though, will it compare to The Dark Knight Rises that did so well over the summer?
You know, hopefully, you know, maybe you can even understand Bane a little better. I saw the Riddler in that and all that, so...
It has all the villains.
It's got it all. You know, I'll check it out. I'll definitely check it out. And speaking of big movies, like, you know, from Batman Live to the wonderful Dark Knight Rises, of course, we have a huge one coming up, The Hobbit.
The Hobbit.
Yes.
Much like The Lord of the Rings, but not Lord of the Rings.
It's the prequel. So we have The Hobbit coming up here, and that is under a lot of controversy because it came out and they said it's going to be one movie, then it says it's going to be two. Now it's going to be a trilogy from one book. It's now going to be three.
So we had the three Lord of the Rings movies.
Yeah, no, we have
for
the three
books.
Hobbit movies. Yeah.
And now we're going to have the three Hobbit movies for one book.
Absolutely.
I'm lost.
As is the rest of the world, but you know, this is the good thing though. They're spreading it apart because it's people are coming in from like his son who came in actually added more to it. So it's like all the backstory and everything brought into one big movie. What a controversy about that is for Peter Jackson's new project is these are going to be using with the most advanced cameras yet.
Advanced?
Yes.
Like what?
Well,
high speed, slow-mo?
Oh, absolutely. We're talking 48 frames a second. That's double anything that's ever been done. Even Avatar was not that good.
Wow.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
So it's going to look really real.
Like, too real. Some actually thought it looked too real when they previewed it.
I can understand that. Why don't they just animate it?
Done before. Thankfully, this time, all live action. The trailer actually looks pretty good. Now, if you look closely at the credits for it, we actually have Martin Freeman playing Frodo. Now, he's actually known for being Watson in the hit BBC show, Sherlock.
I do not watch BBC.
What? Why not?
British Broadcasting Corporation.
Yes.
I am in America.
Well, as an American, I can gladly say I am a fan. Well, so we have him playing at that, as well as Ian McClellan, who's returning as Gandalf.
Ah.
So I'm thinking more of Magneto.
People will be able to make the connection between Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit now.
Absolutely.
When they see Gandalf.
See, there's a recurring character.
Wow.
Definitely something to check out right there for you. And speaking of good movies coming up, there's also another one. I think one you liked coming up here, wasn't it?
Was there?
Yes.
What was it?
I think it was, you just mentioned Lincoln.
Oh, yes. Lincoln is coming out soon. And it's a Steven Spielberg movie. It's
going to
have Daniel Day-Lewis from Last of the Mohicans and Tommy Lee Jones.
Tommy Lee Jones.
So you know it's going to be a blockbuster.
Absolutely. Even that Joseph Gordon-Levitt, who's in everything now.
Yeah, he's getting all the deals because he's a good actor. So I think he's going to add a lot to it.
Shoot, he had Looper, he had Inception, he had...
Batman.
Batman, yeah.
He's probably going to be the next Robin.
No. Spoiler. Absolutely. But, you know, movies like that are expensive. I'm talking like you spend like $50 and like you and Bebe's kids go see in a movie plus the popcorn. It's disgusting.
You have kids?
Well, not another story. But moving on. No, I don't. Moving on. Okay. We do have movies here playing at Johnson County Community College.
One of free which, movies.
Yeah. For free is War Horse.
Have not seen it. Wanted to see it. But if the horse dies, I will walk out of the theater. I don't like to see animals die.
I've seen quite a few movies here at Johnson County Community College for free, which is great. You know, free popcoring, free movie, I'll take it.
Who's all in War Horse?
Well, there's actually quite a few actors in there, many of you have seen, but one that really catches eyes is Benedict Cumberbatch. Now, why this catches my eye, because not only is he actually Sherlock, a recurring character, definitely a rising actor, but he also is Smaug in Lord of the Rings, kind of going back there for you.
Oh, more BBC connections. But Lord of the Rings, I can roll with that. I can roll with that.
And you also have Tom Hiddleston in there. You know, he's from The Avengers.
Ah, yes, one of my favorites. I watched that. He was Loki, wasn't he?
He was Loki.
I will go see this movie then.
I definitely will. Another Steven Spielberg film right there for you. Well, I have to admit, caught my eye there. Definitely something I'll be checking out, hopefully, soon.
I don't know about you, Bill, but I kind of think I'll go see this movie now.
Oh, yeah? Hey, brother, I'll be right there with you. All right. There's so many great films out there. Two of them just showed you right there. But how about we get a little more in detail for all the celebrities, and let's get on to some celebrity gossip right now with our own Natalie Horsch.
Hello, guys.
Hey, Natalie. How you doing, Natalie?
Welcome to Unscripted.
All right. All right, well, we got some great stuff for you. We got breakups, we got weddings, and Lindsay Lohan.
Oh, Lindsay Lohan.
Broke up a wedding.
Not exactly.
Okay.
Close. But first, let's start with Jay-Z and Beyonce. Jay-Z and Beyonce filed for a trademark application for their daughter's name, Blue Ivy, to protect it from being commercial use. However, it was denied because the name is already in use for a company in Boston that is a wedding planning company. So,
kind of like the name of that, Blue Ivy.
Yes. They wanted to start a baby product line using that name. So they wanted to be the only ones to be able to export their daughter, exploit their daughter's
name. I was going to say they're exploiting their own child.
Yes, they want to be the only ones making money off of it.
But that's what celebrity parents do.
Right, right. Well, I guess. You know, with Jay-Z and Beyonce, they don't really need more money.
No, they could give some to me.
Oh, yeah. All right, and then Mark Sanchez and Eva Longoria broke up. Yes, only a couple months together, and it's over.
Wow.
Eva Longoria must be crazy. She's always getting dumped by men.
Actually, I think she did the breaking up.
Oh.
And rightfully so.
Mark's heart shattered. Should move on to Tebow now.
Yeah, exactly. Well, the rumor is that there was just scheduling conflicts and that they, you know, didn't have a lot of time together. You know, Mark Sanchez throwing too many incompletions. And Eva busy getting tattoos removed of her ex-husband, Tony Parker.
Yeah.
So, not a lot of time there.
Oh, my God.
Justin Timberlake and Jessica Biel got married in Italy with friends and family over the weekend. And unfortunately,
heart shattered.
Yes, but none.
She's settling.
That's right.
None of the NSYNC members were there.
No.
Yes, yes. It was rumored that only JC and Chris Kirkpatrick were the ones invited. So drama there. Joey and Lance cut out.
The reunion tour is off.
Yes, I'm guessing.
I get a refund on my tickets.
You might want to get that, yes.
Okay.
All right. And finally, Lindsay Lohan tweeted during the debate. I'm sure you guys follow Lindsay Lohan.
I missed that insight.
Yes. Well, but you know, her opinion on politics is like a cow's opinion. It's moo. So let's go to where Lindsay shines, and that is in the clubs. And that's exactly where she was following an intervention for drugs and alcohol put on by her father and management team.
Ooh,
so
wow.
Shockingly, it didn't work. So now Michael Lohan wants to get a conservatorship like Britney Spears' dad did. However, the problem being Michael's a horrible father and part of the problem.
So, Lindsay seems like a horrible daughter, which is also part of the problem.
Well, I mean, yeah, but it started from the parents. I mean, you know, her mom doing drugs with her dad, you know, putting all her conversations out on the internet. It's just kind of like...
Everybody, awkward. Equal blame.
Yeah. So
this triumvirate.
All right, but that's all I have for you today,
guys. Kind of very shallow and pedantic.
Yes. Thank you, Natalie.
Uh-huh.
Thank you.
All right.
Wow. Well, see, that's actually quite a bit we had going on there today.
It's a packed day.
Packed day. As a matter of fact, I think, guys, that is all the time we have for today for your SNC Unscripted. I'm Bill Butts.
And I'm Connor Cape, and this has been your SNC Unscripted.
You stay classy, Kansas City.
And stay classy.
Soy el mundo.